Chapter 1 of Mansfield Park, three sisters marry. The oldest, Mariah Ward, marries Sir Thomas Bertram, wealthy owner of Mansfield Park, a country estate in Northampton. The second sister, Miss Ward, marries Mr. Norris, a clergyman in the Mansfield Park parish. The third, Miss Frances Ward, marries Mr. Price, a poor, uneducated lieutenant in the Marines, against her family's wishes. Mrs. Price is cut off from the family. Her husband is injured and spends much time and money drinking. Poor and expecting her ninth child, Mrs. Price writes to her sisters asking for help, and Mrs. Norris suggests perhaps her eldest daughter, Fanny, could be fostered at Mansfield Park. In Chapter 2, Fanny Price, a slightly shy child, arrives at Mansfield Park and greets her cousins. Thomas Bertram, the handsome family heir, Edmund, studious and kind, and sisters Mariah and Julia, accustomed to privilege. Gentle Edmund helps her feel at home when she struggles. Sir Thomas helps Fanny's brothers find work and frets over the wasteful behavior of his son Tom. Only once during these years do Fanny and William spend time together, just before he goes to sea. Edmund studies at Oxford to become a clergyman. In Chapter 3, years later, when Fanny is 15, Mr. Norris dies. To pay debts Tom has accrued, Sir Thomas must sell the living to Dr. Grant, who will hold it until his death. Sir Thomas urges his older son to change his wasteful ways. Mrs. Norris moves into a house Sir Thomas owns in town, and Fanny learns he expects her to be her aunt's live-in companion. Mrs. Norris presents a litany of reasons Fanny cannot live with her, and Fanny remains at Mansfield Park. Some months pass before Sir Thomas must travel to Antigua to oversee business at his plantation. He takes Tom with him, hoping to cut his son's disreputable connections, and leaves Edmund in charge. Chapter 1 raises questions about marriages and alliances, presenting the Ward sisters as examples of the kinds of alliances available to women of moderate means in Austen's day. Mrs. Norris is a hypocritical, discontented, snobbish, and stingy woman, reminiscent of some of Charles Dickens's famous characters readers love to hate. Edmund emerges as a serious, kind, and thoughtful man. Sir Thomas's departure for Antigua seems a matter of indifference to his wife and of delight to his daughters. Only Fanny feels genuine regret.